Send you west to barren schools, send your kids to barren schools, a place to realize your dreams, barren schools. Send you west to barren schools, send your kids to barren school, there's no other place like barren schools.
As a neat fit, the neatest ever seen. Tade's feet are neat because his feet are clean. Tade has a neat fit, the neatest ever seen. Tade's feet are neat because his feet are clean. Hello children, how are you doing today? You are welcome once again to this platform, our e-learning platform. I still remain Mrs. Essie Edema. And today I'll take you on social studies, and our topic on social studies is giving first aid to road accident victims. Giving first aid to road accident victims. Remember in our previous lesson, I taught you about first aid, and I told you that first aid is the first treatment or the immediate treatment. When I say immediate, I mean the quick treatment you give to a sick or an injured person before taking him or her to the hospital. And I also told you that a sick or an injured person is called what? It's called what? The victim. And the person that is applying the first aid is called who? The first aider. The person that is applying the first aid is called who? The first aider. But today, I'm going to be taking you of how giving first aid to road accident victim. How do we give first aid to road accident victim? That is what we are going to look at today. Okay, like I told you, I'm going to be teaching you on how to give first aid to road accident victim. Okay, you don't just give first aid to a road accident victim. Maybe maybe there was an accident on the way. You don't just come and apply first aid on the victim. You check if the injury is minor or a major injury. What do I mean by that? If it's something that you can handle. If it's a minor injury, something that you can handle. But if it's a major injury, what do? You quickly rush that person to the hospital. So we are going to look at how to give first aid to accident victim. And I told you that a victim is the person that is involved in the accident. Okay, number one thing you have to do is to apply disinfectant, like you apply your hand sanitizer on your hands. Why do you apply your hand sanitizer? Like we all know, hand sanitizer is a common thing that everybody use now because of COVID-19. You apply it to make your hands neat. You know, I always tell you that your hands are very dirty. You cannot see those dirty while looking at it with your naked eyes. When you use a microscope and you look at your hands, you know that your hands are very dirty. So number one thing you have to do is to apply hand sanitizer on your hands. Or you can quickly wash your hands, but the best way to do it is to apply hand sanitizer. Another thing to do, you wear your hand glove. I showed you your hand glove in the first aid bus. You wear your hand glove. Why do you wear your hand glove? You are not supposed to touch an injured person with your naked hands. You can see in the hospital that the doctors, they usually wear their hand gloves. You are not supposed to touch any injured person or any person that is sick that you want to examine. You don't touch with your naked hands. You touch with your hands. You are not supposed to touch a victim with your bare hands. You are supposed to wear your hand gloves. So that is another thing you do. After applying your hand sanitizer, you wear your hand gloves. Now another one is, after that, you check the wound very well. Check the injury very well. If the person that is injured, you check the injury very well. And what will you do? You apply, use your cotton wool and apply antiseptic. You apply your antiseptic. What are those antiseptic? Your Dettol, your TCP, your and so on and so forth. You apply them into the injury to clean the injury. You clean the surface of the injury. Okay, another one is you cover the injury with plaster. Now, if there is bleeding, if the person is bleeding, what will you do? You apply methylated spirit or your iodine. You apply your methylated spirit to stop the bleeding. Okay, after
apply your plaster, then you give the victim pain relief. What are those pain relief? I told you that your paracetamol, your Panadol, your Fensic, all these are pain relief. You give the victim pain relief so that the victim will not feel, will feel less or little pain. Then after that, what will you do?
After that, you take the victim to the nearest hospital. You take the victim to the nearest hospital. So let's write it down, the ways. Remember, we are talking about giving first aid to road accident victims, and here are the steps. And I want you to know something before I continue. These steps are for minor road accidents. They are for minor road accidents, not for major road accidents. Please, if somebody is involved in an accident and you realize that the injury is a major injury, please, the person should be taken to the hospital immediately. Okay, let's start. Number one thing to do is to wash your hands or use the hand sanitizer. You wash your hands or you use the hand sanitizer. I've just explained that. Number two, wear your hand gloves. Number two is what? Wear your hand gloves. Number three, clean the wound with antiseptic or disinfectant like Dettol, Azide or TCP or any other one, any other antiseptic or disinfectant you know. Okay, number four, use the methylated spirit or iodine when there is bleeding. When you realize that there is bleeding, severe bleeding, what do? You use your methylated spirit or you use your iodine. Then number five, cover the wound with plaster or bandages. Cover the wound with plaster or bandages. Okay, now number six, give the victim pain reliever. You give the victim any kind of pain reliever. For example, the common one we have is the paracetamol or your Panadol. Those are the common ones you give the victim. Now number seven, take the victim or victims. Victims is when they are more than one. Then the victim is only one person, but when they are more than one, you call them victims. You take them to the nearest hospital or clinic. So these are the steps to take when somebody is involved in road accidents, the steps to take in treating that person. Okay, now we are going to talk about uses of some first aid materials. What are the uses of some first aid materials? Now, number one, we have the water. What do we use the water for? For washing blood off from the injury. You wash blood, use the water to wash blood off from the injury. Then number two, we have the bandages. They are used for dressing and tying wounds. I've showed you the bandage, how the bandage looks like. Now number three, scissors. They are used for cutting materials such as the plaster, the glues, the bandages, and so on. That is what we use the scissors for. Remember, all these are inside the first aid box. They are materials inside the first aid box. Now, number four, we have the cutting wool. They are used for cleaning and dressing wounds. Cutting wool is used for cleaning and dressing wounds. Number five, the plaster. It is used to hold the cutting wool in place after dressing the wound. And number six, we have the methylated spirit. It is used to clean wound and stop bleeding. It is used to clean the wound and to stop the wound from bleeding. That is what we use the methylated spirit for. Now, number seven, we have the antiseptic or disinfectant. They are used to clean the wound to prevent infection. That is what we use them for. Like your Dettol, your Azide, they are used to prevent infection. Okay. I hope the lesson is so interesting. I hope you can tell me how to apply first aid on road accident victim. And you can also tell me some of the materials that are used in first aid and their uses. I hope you can tell me that. Now it's time for your own activity. Now, your own work on the board. Number one, explain how first aid can be applied on road accident victims or victims. Explain how first aid can be applied on road accident victim or the victims. Now, number two, state the uses of the following. A, plaster. B, disinfectant. C, water. D, bandages. And E, cutting wound. I hope you've taken that down. All right, it has been an interesting lesson. Even me, I enjoyed myself. Hope you do too. See you next time and stay safe. Be good boys and girls and help mommy at home, right? Help mommy and daddy at home. Bye.